Hi, I'm Gunnery Sergeant Carmen Cordova. Join Petty Officer Chris Avant and me on Navy Marine Corps News. This week, Exercise Summer Storm gives sailors and Marines realistic combat training in Southern California. Find out about a great benefit, Navy lodges, affordable places to stay near vacation sites around the world. And we'll take you to the gridiron for the first game in the Naval Academy football season. These stories and more on Navy Marine Corps News.
This week on Navy Marine Corps News, Exercise Summer Storm gives 2,000 sailors and Marines realistic combat training in Southern California. Find out about a great benefit, Navy lodges, affordable places to stay near Navy bases and vacation sites around the world. And we'll take you to the gridiron for a look at the Naval Academy football team's season opener as the midshipmen took on Wake Forest. These stories and more next on Navy Marine Corps News.
Welcome to Navy Marine Corps News. I'm Gunnery Sergeant Carmen Cordova.
And I'm Petty Officer Chris Avant. We begin this week with sailors and Marines training the way they fight.
Exercise Summer Storm, held at Marine Corps Base Camp Pendleton, California, gave Navy and Marine Corps reservists hands-on realistic combat training.
Petty Officer Sonia Hammond of our San Diego detachment takes us there.
More than 2,000 sailors and Marines from Marine Corps Reserve units across the country participated in amphibious operations off the coast of Southern California for their annual two-week training exercise.
It helps us out a lot if we were called into a combat situation. This would be what we're doing. It gives us a lot of confidence doing training like this because we don't get to do it every day.
Assaulting a beach in Tennessee or Illinois isn't the norm. That's why it's a valuable experience for these reservists to have this hands-on training.
Basically everything we're doing, practicing what we do in normal wartime, so it's pretty important. A lot of people look at it as to sharpen up their skills and basically what we're trained for, and it's to help defend our country.
That's the situation we'd be put into in real life. We wouldn't be sitting back there with each other doing it. We'd be having to salt beaches. It's put me into a real life situation, and I know how I'll react in that situation now.
And knowing how to react in a real life situation is a matter of life or death for the corpsmen who treat the injured Marines in the field.
In a wartime situation, you know, you have to be fast on your feet. You have to, you know, be able to, you know, just react. And if you can't do that, then, you know, a Marine dies.
During war, they have to be ready for anything.
They treated me by giving me an IV to try to rehydrate me, and putting a saline dressing over the wound and trying to get me shipped out as soon as possible. I think they did a really good job. I was impressed.
The sailors and Marines were also impressed with the training they received.
And this gives us a great opportunity to get out into an environment to perform these exercises in a type of a live atmosphere.
I think it's essential for every Marine to come out here. Seeing is that being a Marine, your first and foremost job is a basic rifleman, meaning that you go to war anytime.
And this type of real-life training is what continues to keep our Navy and Marine Corps Reserve forces at a high state of combat readiness at all times. Petty Officer Sonia Hammond, Navy Marine Corps News.
Being ready and trained to answer the call. That's what the Navy Marine Corps team's all about.
They sure are, and it's great that they can take part in that kind of training and they're motivated about being there.
In other news, many sailors and Marines may not know exactly who Zachary Fisher is, but his actions, support, and friendship to the men and women of the Navy Marine Corps team runs deep.
Mr. Fisher, a longtime supporter of all men and women in the armed forces, was recently recognized by the Commander-in-Chief for his selfless devotion to the military. President Clinton awarded him our nation's highest civilian award, the Medal of Freedom.
Tom Brokaw of NBC's Nightly News introduces us to the man who has truly gone above and beyond the call for the men and women in the military.
His report is this week's Focus on the Fleet.
President Clinton tonight no doubt welcomed the opportunity to stand side by side with a genuine American hero as the president awarded the Medal of Freedom, this country's highest civilian award. It went to a New Yorker who has a special place in the hearts of all American military families. and they have something to prove it. Zachary Fisher, the son of Russian immigrants, quitting school to take a bricklaying job in his modest Brooklyn community.
If something has to come from within you.
Hard work led Fisher to become one of New York's most accomplished developers, helping to create the most famous skyline in the world. A bad knee kept him out of World War II. He swore then he would devote his life to giving back to those who had fought for his freedom.
Well, all they're doing is giving their lives, that's all.
He has donated more than $8 million to the families of those who died serving their nation.
Well, I'm not about to forget about them.
1983, 241 Marines killed in Lebanon, $10,000 to every family. 1989, 47 dead sailors on the battleship Iowa, $25,000 to each family. 1998, soon money will be sent to the families of those who lost loved ones in the Africa terrorist bombings. The tragedies in all of these families softened by the generous hands of a one-time bricklayer.
A well-deserved honor for a man who has given so much to all of us.
Our thanks to NBC Nightly News and Tom Brokaw for that report.
Switching gears, access to information has become the norm for sailors and Marines around the world.
Sure has. And the Internet has made finding out almost anything as easy as clicking a mouse button.
And the Marine Corps is making sure that finding out anything you want to know about the Corps stays easy and entertaining.
Corporal David Annarino went to the Pentagon to check out the Marine Corps website and its webmaster.
USMC.mil is one of the most up-to-date, most informative sites on the net for Marines, their families, and anyone else who is curious about the few, the proud. And Sergeant Will Donaldson is the one who keeps it up-to-date and running.
It takes a while. It takes some time. But we're having fun. We're doing a lot.
Click on this automated site to read through current stories sent in from the fleet.
This story right here was put in from Okinawa. We never touched it. I've never even read this one yet.
Go to the Commandant's page to see what's important to him.
And this was actually a Navy Times article that the Commandant wanted higher vivs on, so we threw that out there.
Click here to download or submit your own images.
I'll take a look at them and screen them. Hit yay or nay right there, and they're either on the website or we nuke them.
And look at this. Now you can download Marines Magazine before it even hits the stands. For you computer junkies, soon you'll be able to watch this show without even leaving your computer.
And what we'll do is we'll pull selected clips from it, put it online, and let people choose ones that they'd like to watch.
Maybe your son is deployed on a Marine Expeditionary Unit. Soon you'll be able to keep track of him via the net.
We'll be able to modify this in real time. So the day that the Mew moves around, if we want to show that to the world, we can.
USMC.mil is a library of knowledge with anything and everything you'll ever want to know about the Marine Corps. So bookmark it today. Corporal David Annarino, Navy Marine Corps News.
I've already got it bookmarked.
I hope so, Gunny. And here's another great place to bookmark.
Sailors and Marines can now try out web-based computer courses.
That's right. Everything from beginning word processing courses to highly technical computer skills can be found at usn.netg.com.
Now, once there, type in USN as both the password and the username.
Then begin downloading the course of your choice.
Now, this is only for a trial period, so check it out. Fill in the online feedback form if you like the courses.
Now, hey, don't touch that dial, because when we come back, a young man fulfills his dream of becoming a sailor in the United States Navy.
Stay right there.
Every morning, you know, but you have to have your head about you. I mean, it's a dangerous job, what we do, and most of us are 18 to 19 years old, and first time out away from home, so you're a little scared, a little timid, but once you get into it, it's a blast.
Everybody has to be a team on the bridge, you know. It's a very serious situation up there, navigating a million-dollar ship. You know, a lot of responsibility, even as a seaman, on me, you know, standing to watch by myself.
Each individual is responsible for the safety of the whole squadron. Because, you know, somebody makes one mistake and that, you know, that can cause the aircraft to crash.
We got to be ready to, you know, read these instruments and take down what's going to happen. If something goes down, you want to be able to bring it back up in less than a half hour. You can't do that if you're not up to your full standards.
If you're not able to perform your job and work as a teammate, then your shipmates, they're going to feel that you're not pulling your own weight, so maybe not trust you as much.
Everybody depends on each other because we're in a closed environment, and it's a hazardous environment because we're underwater.
People get hurt, basic, plain and simple, people get hurt. You always, when you're doing a daily inspection of the aircraft, you are looking at the airplane, you're telling the air crew that this airplane is safe to fly, and you have to stake your reputation on it.
Welcome back to Navy Marine Corps News.
Let the journey begin. That is the motto for the men and women hoping to join the U.S. Navy.
And for one young sailor aboard USS Saipan, the journey to that goal began in his native country of Bosnia.
Petty Officer Kurt Riggs of our Sigonella Detachment brings us the story.
From the war-torn country of Bosnia to the USS Saipan, that is the journey that's been made by a very unique sailor. His dream was not only to become an American citizen, but a United States Navy sailor.
I joined U.S. Navy because I wanted to see the world, get new experience, and get college education.
19-year-old seaman apprentice Dejan Jozic came to the United States with his family from Bosnia 3 years ago to start a new life.
We had to leave because just the situation over there, there was a lot of people dying, and we didn't want to be one of them. We still wanted to live, and we had to leave the country. To leave everything that we have just so we can survive, and we came here, and I'm glad we're here. I'm glad I'm in the Navy.
In July 1997, Jozic decided to see what the Navy had to offer and earn some money for college. He is striking for the P-end rate and has excelled in every challenge he's taken on.
His performance has been outstanding. You give him stuff to work on, he gets it done.
Furthering his education is one of Seaman Jozic's top priorities, and he is currently working on his college degree while on board Saipan. He enjoys working in customer service as a PN because it has helped him improve his English.
Probably the best thing that I like about PN's world is that I like working with the people and helping them out.
The major changes in his life have been both challenging and rewarding.
When I came here, I got totally free. I'm happy I'm here. Life here is just great. I've been accepted like everybody other, and I like it here. I like it a lot.
From the USS Saipan, I'm Petty Officer Kurt Riggs, Navy Marine Corps News.
I'm originally from Panama, and I can definitely understand Seaman Jozic's pride in being an American and being in the American Armed Forces.
But hey, you can't beat the U.S. Navy as far as I'm concerned.
Same for the Corps. Unfortunately, there are groups who see sailors and Marines as targets. Terrorists resort to acts of violence to further their political goals. Petty Officer Raina Williams tells us how each of us can protect ourselves against the terrorist threat.
The exposure of individual sailors and Marines to acts of terrorism is something the Navy and Marine Corps take very seriously.
Well, the threat is very serious, and everybody should take it seriously, as indicated by the bombings in East Africa, Nairobi and Dar es Salaam, following on the heels of the bombing in Saudi Arabia of Khobar Towers. It pretty much indicates that anybody and everybody, particularly overseas, is susceptible to terrorism.
There are steps we can all take to reduce the risk to ourselves and our families. Marine Corps individual countermeasures trainers suggest some basic rules to follow, whether you're assigned overseas or in the United States.
First, keep a low profile. Americans, American military in particular, tend to stand out. You want to try and blend in. You want to vary your routine, change the time in the morning that you something as simple as going out and getting your paper. Be aware of your surroundings. It's very hard to spot something abnormal unless you know what is normal.
These same precautions should be followed by the entire family. For example, if you're living overseas, even in a low threat area, it's important to have a family emergency action plan.
This is a plan of action that you're going to take in case of any emergency whatsoever, be it a burglar, a fire, or a terrorist incident.
If you or your family plan to travel for vacation or change duty stations, there are also easy ways to reduce risk. If you're driving, make sure you know how to get where you're going before you start. When you're going by air, try to book a non-stop direct flight and pick your tickets up in advance, not at the airport.
The key thing you want to look at is do not become complacent, and don't think that terrorism can't happen to you.
Petty Officer Raina Williams, Navy Marine Corps News.
Those are tips we all need to know and use.
They sure are. As the saying goes, complacency kills.
That's also true when talking about health issues.
Petty Officer Joe Winton of our Norfolk Detachment tells us about one such health issue that all young male sailors and Marines need to be aware of, and how early detection of this disease could save your life.
A silent killer is stalking some of our shipmates, a disease which is relatively unknown, but is the number one cancer in men ages 17 to 35, testicular cancer.
Until I read this article that was in a George Washington paper, I didn't know nothing about it. As I read the article over and over, I was like, man, these symptoms are me. I need to get to medical. And as I learned more about the disease, the article might have saved my life.
The biggest thing is don't be afraid to tell somebody else. Because, you know, if I wouldn't have read the article in that paper, who knows what would happen. You know, I got over my nervousness and I went and got it taken care of.
This cancer can attack and kill very swiftly, yet it has an extremely high survival rate if detected early.
Now, you don't need to be alarmed if there's an abnormality on your testicle, if there's a lump or a bump. There are many reasons for there to be lumps or bumps, such as infections and things like that. But to make sure that it's not a cancer, you need to have your medical personnel evaluate you.
The survival rate can be more than 90%.
If you notice a problem, if there's any changes in the size of your testicle, if you feel any pain, if there's any lumps, go down and get it checked out. I feel fortunate that I did go down and have it checked out early. Because if I hadn't, and if I had waited, there could have been some dire consequences. I'm fortunate that I detected this cancer early and that I'll be around to see my daughter go to college.
Self-exams are the key, and early intervention by your doctor can make sure you stay healthy. Petty Officer Joe Winton, Navy Marine Corps News.
Early detection can't be stressed enough, so make sure you're checking yourself on a regular basis because it could mean the difference between life and death.
And it's good to know that Navy medicine is there to support and help heal you should you have the need.
With many people changing to the new work in uniform and the winter season about to set in, it's a great idea to have the Navy Uniform Support Center's phone number handy.
That's right. The Support Center's 24-hour hotline can be reached at 1-800-368-4088, or if you're overseas, dial DSN 680-8586.
Now stay right where you are, because when we come back, we'll take you to see some of the best Navy lodges in the world.
Don't you go away.
The September All Hands magazine is out and it's got a message. It's not just a job, it's your job. This issue is filled with information about the places our jobs take us, like Earl, New Jersey. Dive into Navy history with the story of the ghost ship USS Monitor. Find out how Navy divers helped recover and preserve this Civil War ironclad. Then check out More Than a Passing Shadow, A Day in the Life of the MECPON. The story takes you through a typical day with an untypical man. Turn the page and meet the sailors of the year. Here you can learn what makes them the best of the best. Bubers has moved to Millington, Tennessee. Drive South lets you experience this friendly town. Interconnectivity puts you inside the minds of a sailor and detailer as they decide what's best for the sailor and the Navy. All this and more in the September edition of All Hands. Grab a copy today.
Speeding can give you a ride you'll never forget.
Thanks for staying with us.
Staying inexpensively at Navy lodges is a great benefit to being in the military.
They're clean, safe, and affordable, as well as being near some of the best vacation spots in the world.
Petty Officer Tom Cridell takes us around the globe to get a look at what you can expect from these great places for sailors and Marines to kick back and relax.
We're going to start our tour at the Navy Lodge right here in our nation's capital. Now, this lodge has great rooms at a fraction of the price of other hotels in the city, and it's close to everything on your list of hot sights to see.
You can start your tour at the White House, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. You may even be able to take a tour. Other downtown stops include the Washington Monument, Lincoln Memorial, and the Vietnam Veterans Memorial. And no sailor's trip to Washington would be complete without a trip to the Navy Memorial. These great Navy lodges serve military members and their families all over the world. And the next stop on our tour is in the Far East in Atsugi, Japan. Here you'll be able to soak in some Japanese culture in the nearby city of Kamakura. Or if you want a little taste of American culture with a Japanese flair, take a trip to Disneyland in Tokyo. Now that you've gotten a taste of life in the big city, we'll jet back to the States and check out the Big Apple. Here you can stay at the Navy Lodge at Staten Island, just a short ferry ride away from the hustle and bustle of Manhattan. Visit the Empire State Building, Times Square, or maybe even catch a Yankees game. There are literally thousands of places you can go in New York, and once you get to the Navy Lodge, it's all up to you. But lodges aren't just near big cities. Next, we're off to the West Coast for a little time in the surf and sand. This lodge is on the island of Coronado, California, and it's not just near the beach, it's on the beach. It's also close to the Naval Amphibious Base, Coronado, and the 32nd Street Naval Stations. You can experience downtown San Diego, shopping on Orange Avenue, and the world-famous Hotel del Coronado. And for the avid golfer, there's a beautiful 18-hole course just a 5-iron away. Back on the East Coast, our tour winds up at Dam Neck, Virginia, where you'll find another Navy lodge that comes with a beach. This one recently celebrated its grand opening, and like most lodges, features all the comforts of home.
The laundry room is nice. It's right next to the rooms. The room is really big. It's got two nice big beds in it, and it's got a nice little kitchenette. You know, it has everything in it. All you have to do is get the food.
With excellent rooms at an excellent price, a Navy Lodge is the perfect place to come home to when you're on vacation. And if you want to know where you can find a lodge, you can check out this directory at any Navy Lodge or Exchange. Petty Officer Tom Cradell, Navy Marine Corps News.
You know, my family and I have stayed at Navy Lodges all across the country, and we're always satisfied with those facilities.
Me too. The lodge in Staten Island is a great place if you're in the New York area.
Now we turn to the Navy sports scene. For their season opener, the Naval Academy midshipmen kicked off the 98-99 football season against Wake Forest.
Petty Officer Scott Prather tells us how they fared as they took on the Demon Deacons.
Navy kicked off the season at Wake Forest in front of a crowd of over 26,000 and a nationwide primetime audience. Senior defensive captain Jason Snyder fired up the midshipmen with a pregame locker room pep talk.
Disappointed the guy next to you. Let's play for each other.
And it must have worked, as the midshipmen struck first with a touchdown. The score was set up by a 41-yard pass from quarterback Steve Holly to Mark Mills. Three plays later, Holly scored on a 5-yard quarterback keeper around the right side. Wake Forest would later counter with a 41-yard field goal. With the score 7-3, Navy took over from their own 37-yard line and scored six plays later with a 38-yard touchdown pass from Holly to Brian Reed. Wake Forest would score a touchdown before the half to make the score 14-10. In the second half, Navy's offense couldn't get it going. But the Demon Deacons offense came alive, scoring 16 second half points and dumping the midshipmen 26-14. Navy coach Charlie Weatherby says his squad showed some of their firepower, but must learn to keep it going for 60 minutes.
I think overall, I think we learned a lot in that football game. I think we matured in that football game, and I think you're going to see a much improved football team coming up this next week.
The midshipmen now return home with an 0-1 record to host Kent State, but they hope to take out their frustrations of their opening night loss on the Golden Flashes. Petty Officer Scott Prather, Navy Marine Corps News.
A great opening game. You know, they really had the advantage there in the first and second quarter, but just kind of faded off in the second half.
Mm-hmm. I watched the game on ESPN, and I think the Navy's going to have a great season this year.
Look out, Army. Too bad it couldn't go in the win column, though. But you know, they're ready for the Kent State home opener.
You can watch our show for Academy football highlights throughout the season.
Now let's go to Ship Shape and find out how to build up our arms with the tricep kickback.
It's time to get ship shape. Hi, I'm Clark Bartram, former Marine and internationally ranked amateur natural bodybuilder.
And I'm HM2 Jeff Bramstead, U.S. Navy SEAL.
Today we're on the flight deck of USS Essex, LHD-2 in San Diego.
Before we get started, we have some motivated sailors from the Essex to help us out. We have SM3, David Neal.
How you doing?
And IC3, Craig Kello. You guys ready to get ship shape?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
yeah. That's great. There's no time like the present to start living healthy and get in shape.
You're absolutely right, Jeff. And the time to be fit for life is now. And it's easy when you're healthy and living right, it's easier to stay motivated and positive about the world around you. Well, today we're going to demonstrate one of my favorite exercises.
One of yours.
The tricep kickback.
And I don't think he's talking about kicking back on the couch either.
That's absolutely right. So let's get motivated and let's do some. The first thing you need to do is go get a dumbbell from the ship gym.
All right. I'm right here.
Okay, now take the dumbbell and bend over using your free hand as a brace. Spread your legs evenly for support. Now lift the dumbbell so your arm is bent at the elbow. Now extend your arm all the way back till it's straight. Now lower the weight back down. Okay, now you want to make sure you keep your back straight. And as always, guys, breathing is very important. You should be exhaling on the effort and inhaling as you lower the weight. Tell me, Jeff, do you feel it?
I feel it, Clark. One thing great about doing triceps is you get a great burn.
If it's burning in the muscle, that means that you're working that muscle. Guys, is it burning in your muscle?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Is it burning in your muscle?
Oh, yeah.
Another way to do these is to brace yourself on a chair or on a bench.
That's right. And don't forget, you need to stretch before and after you exercise.
Stretching is very important. Well, that's all the time we have for today. So do some tricep kickbacks.
And remember, think strong, be strong, and make it happen.
So get ship shape.
You know, it doesn't look hard, but you are going to get a great arm workout.
And you won't be able to argue with the positive results you'll see.
That's right. Well, that's the show for this week. As always, we'd like to hear your thoughts and ideas about Navy Marine Corps news. So call our feedback line or send us an email.
You'll see the email address as well as the phone number and mailing address again in a minute. But before we go, BZ to the sailors of USS John L. Hall.
While on routine patrol, the crew recently recovered 2,700 pounds of cocaine in international waters near Panama.
Great job. We'd also like to say well done to the sailors of USS Haler and USS Samuel B. Roberts.
Both ships were recently chosen as winners of the Commander Naval Surface Force Atlantic Intelligence Excellence Award.
Keep up the good work. And a big welcome goes out to our new viewers at WBSU Channel 5 at Ball State University in Muncie, Indiana.
We'd also like to thank the sailors aboard USS Kitty Hawk, forward deployed in Yokosuka, Japan, for watching the show.
We leave you this week with a look at Marines participating in some very realistic training during Cooperative Osprey 98.
Have a great week.
We'll see you next week.
More than 2,000 sailors and Marines from Marine Corps Reserve units across the country participated in amphibious operations off the coast of Southern California for their annual two-week training exercise.
It helps us out a lot if we were called into a combat situation. This would be what we're doing. It gives us a lot of confidence doing training like this because we don't get to do it every day.
Assaulting a beach in Tennessee or Illinois isn't the norm. That's why it's a valuable experience for these reservists to have this hands-on training.
Basically everything we're doing, practicing what we do in normal war, wartime, so it's pretty important. A lot of people look at it as sharpen up their skills and basically what we're trained for, and it's to help defend our country.
That's the situation we'd be put into in real life. We wouldn't be sitting back there with each other doing it. We'd be having to salt beaches. It's put me into a real life situation. And I know how I'll react in that situation now.
And knowing how to react in a real life situation is a matter of life or death for the corpsmen who treat the injured Marines in the field.
In a wartime situation, you know, you have to be fast on your feet. You have to, you know, be able to, you know, just react. And if you can't do that, then, you know, a Marine dies.
During war, they have to be ready for anything.
They treated me by giving me an IV to try to rehydrate me, putting a saline dressing over the wound and trying to get me shipped out as soon as possible. I think they did a really good job. I was impressed.
The sailors and Marines were also impressed with the training they received.
And this gives us a great opportunity to get out into an environment to perform these exercises in a type of a live atmosphere.
I think it's essential for every Marine to come out here. Seeing is that being a Marine, your first and foremost job is a basic rifleman, meaning that you go to war anytime.
And this type of real-life training is what continues to keep our Navy and Marine Corps Reserve forces at a high state of combat readiness at all times. Petty Officer Sonia Hammond, Navy Marine Corps News.
President Clinton tonight no doubt welcomed the opportunity to stand side by side with a genuine American hero as the president awarded the Medal of Freedom, this country's highest civilian award. It went to a New Yorker who has a special place in the hearts of all American military families, and they have something to prove it. Zachary Fisher, the son of Russian immigrants, quitting school to take a bricklaying job in his modest Brooklyn community.
If something has to come from within you.
Hard work led Fisher to become one of New York's most accomplished developers, helping to create the most famous skyline in the world. A bad knee kept him out of World War II. He swore then he would devote his life to giving back to those who had fought for his freedom.
Well, all they're doing is giving their lives, that's all.
He has donated more than $8 million to the families of those who died serving their nation.
Well, I'm not about to forget about them.
1983, 241 Marines killed in Lebanon, $10,000 to every family. 1989, 47 dead sailors on the battleship Iowa, $25,000 to each family. 1998, soon money will be sent to the families of those who lost loved ones in the Africa terrorist bombings. The tragedies in all of these families softened by the generous hands of a one-time bricklayer.
USMC.mil is one of the most up-to-date, most informative sites on the net for Marines, their families, and anyone else who is curious about the few, the proud. And Sergeant Will Donaldson is the one who keeps it up-to-date and running.
It takes a while. It takes some time. But we're having fun. We're doing a lot.
Click on this automated site to read through current stories sent in from the fleet.
This story right here was put in from Okinawa. We never touched it. I've never even read this one yet.
Go to the Commandant's page to see what's important to him.
And this was actually a Navy Times article that the Commandant wanted higher vivs on, so we threw that out there.
Click here to download or submit your own images.
I'll take a look at them and screen them. Hit yay or nay right there, and they're either on the website or we nuke them.
And look at this. Now you can download Marines Magazine before it even hits the stands. For you computer junkies, soon you'll be able to watch this show without even leaving your computer.
And what we'll do is we'll pull selected clips from it, put it online, and let people choose ones that they'd like to watch.
Maybe your son is deployed on a Marine Expeditionary Unit. Soon you'll be able to keep track of him via the net.
We'll be able to modify this in real time. So the day that the Mew moves around, if we want to show that to the world, we can.
USMC.mil is a library of knowledge with anything and everything you'll ever want to know about the Marine Corps. So bookmark it today. Corporal David Annarino, Navy Marine Corps News.
From the war-torn country of Bosnia to the USS Saipan,
That is the journey that's been made by a very unique sailor. His dream was not only to become an American citizen, but a United States Navy sailor.
I joined U.S. Navy because I wanted to see the world, get new experience, and get college education.
19-year-old seaman apprentice Dejan Josic came to the United States with his family from Bosnia 3 years ago to start a new life.
We had to leave because just the situation over there, there was a lot of people dying, and we didn't want to be one of them. We still wanted to live, and we had to leave the country, to leave everything that we had just so we can survive. And we came here, and I'm glad we're here. I'm glad I'm in the Navy.
In July 1997, Josic decided to see what the Navy had to offer and earn some money for college. He is striking for the P-end rate and has excelled in every challenge he's taken on.
His performance has been outstanding. You give him stuff to work on, he gets it done.
Furthering his education is one of Seaman Josic's top priorities, and he is currently working on his college degree while on board Saipan. He enjoys working in customer service as a PN because it has helped him improve his English.
Probably the best thing that I like about PN's world is that I like working with the people and helping them out.
The major changes in his life have been both challenging and rewarding.
When I came here, I got totally free. I'm happy I'm here. Life here is just great. I've been accepted like everybody other, and I like it here. I like it a lot.
From the USS Saipan, I'm Petty Officer Kurt Riggs, Navy Marine Corps News.
The exposure of individual sailors and Marines to acts of terrorism is something the Navy and Marine Corps take very seriously.
Well, the threat is very serious, and everybody should take it seriously, as indicated by the bombings in East Africa, Nairobi and Dar es Salaam, following on the heels of the bombing in Saudi Arabia of Khobar Towers. It pretty much indicates that anybody and everybody, particularly overseas, is susceptible to terrorism.
There are steps we can all take to reduce the risk to ourselves and our families. Marine Corps individual countermeasures trainers suggest some basic rules to follow, whether you're assigned overseas or in the United States.
First, keep a low profile. American military in particular, tend to stand out. You want to try and blend in. You want to vary your routine, change the time in the morning that you, something as simple as going out and getting your paper. Be aware of your surroundings. It's very hard to spot something abnormal unless you know what is normal.
These same precautions should be followed by the entire family. For example, if you're living overseas, even in a low threat area, it's important to have a family emergency action plan.
This is a plan of action that you're going to take in case of any emergency whatsoever, be it a burglar, a fire, or a terrorist incident.
If you or your family plan to travel for vacation or change duty stations, there are also easy ways to reduce risk. If you're driving, make sure you know how to get where you're going before you start. When you're going by air, try to book a non-stop direct flight and pick your tickets up in advance, not at the airport.
The key thing you want to look at is do not become complacent, and don't think that terrorism can't happen to you.
Petty Officer Raina Williams, Navy Marine Corps News.
Some of our shipmates, a disease which is relatively unknown, but is the number one cancer in men ages 17 to 35, testicular cancer.
Until I read this article that was in the George Washington paper, I didn't know nothing about it. As I read the article over and over, I was like, man, these symptoms are me. I need to get to medical. And as I learned more about the disease, the article might have saved my life.
The biggest thing is, don't be afraid to tell somebody else. Because, you know, if I wouldn't have read the article in that paper, who knows what would happen. You know, I got over my nervousness and I went and got it taken care of.
This cancer can attack and kill very swiftly, yet it has an extremely high survival rate if detected early.
Hey, you don't need to be alarmed if there's an abnormality on your testicle, if there's a lump or a bump. There are many reasons for there to be lumps or bumps, such as infections and things like that. But to make sure that it's not a cancer, you need to have your medical personnel evaluate you.
The survival rate can be more than 90%.
If you notice a problem, if there's any changes in
the size of your testicle. If you feel any pain, if there's any lumps, go down and get it checked out. I feel fortunate that I did go down and have it checked out early, because if I hadn't and if I had waited, there could have been some dire consequences. I'm fortunate that I detected this cancer early and that I'll be around to see my daughter go to college.
Self-exams are the key, and early intervention by your doctor can make sure you stay healthy. Petty Officer Joe Winton, Navy Marine Corps News.
We're going to start our tour at the Navy Lodge right here in our nation's capital. Now, this lodge has great rooms at a fraction of the price of other hotels in the city, and it's close to everything on your list of hot sights to see.
You can start your tour at the White House, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. You may even be able to take a tour. Other downtown stops include the Washington Monument, Lincoln Memorial, and the Vietnam Veterans Memorial. And no sailor's trip to Washington would be complete without a trip to the Navy Memorial. These great Navy lodges serve military members and their families all over the world. And the next stop on our tour is in the Far East in Atsugi, Japan. Here you'll be able to soak in some Japanese culture in the nearby city of Kamakura. Or if you want a little taste of American culture with a Japanese flair, take a trip to Disneyland in Tokyo. Now that you've gotten a taste of life in the big city, we'll jet back to the States and check out the Big Apple. Here you can stay at the Navy Lodge at Staten Island, just a short ferry ride away from the hustle and bustle of Manhattan. Visit the Empire State Building, Times Square, or maybe even catch a Yankees game. There are literally thousands of places you can go in New York, and once you get to the Navy Lodge, it's all up to you. But lodges aren't just near big cities. Next, we're off to the West Coast for a little time in the surf and sand. This lodge is on the island of Coronado, California, and it's not just near the beach, it's on the beach. It's also close to the Naval Amphibious Base, Coronado, and the 32nd Street Naval Stations. You can experience downtown San Diego, shopping on Orange Avenue, and the world-famous Hotel del Coronado. And for the avid golfer, there's a beautiful 18-hole course just a 5-iron away. Back on the East Coast, our tour winds up at Dam Neck, Virginia, where you'll find another Navy lodge that comes with a beach. This one recently celebrated its grand opening, and like most lodges, features all the comforts of home.
The laundry room is nice. It's right next to the rooms. The room is really big. It's got two nice big beds in it, and it's got a nice little kitchenette. You know, it has everything in it. All you have to do is get the food.
With excellent rooms at an excellent price, a Navy Lodge is the perfect place to come home to when you're on vacation. And if you want to know where you can find a lodge, you can check out this directory at any Navy Lodge or Exchange. Petty Officer Tom Cridell, Navy Marine Corps News.
Navy kicked off the season at Wake Forest in front of a crowd of over 26,000 and a nationwide primetime audience. Senior defensive captain Jason Snyder fired up the midshipmen with a pregame locker room pep talk.
The guy next to you. Let's play for each other.
And it must have worked, as the midshipmen struck first with a touchdown. The score was set up by a 41-yard pass from quarterback Steve Holly to Mark Mills. Three plays later, Holly scored on a 5-yard quarterback keeper around the right side. Wake Forest would later counter with a 41-yard field goal. With the score 7-3, Navy took over from their own 37-yard line and scored six plays later with a 38-yard touchdown pass from Holly to Brian Reed. Wake Forest would score a touchdown before the half to make the score 14-10. In the second half, Navy's offense couldn't get it going. But the Demon Deacons' offense came alive, scoring 16 second-half points and dumping the midshipmen 26-14. Navy coach Charlie Weatherby says his squad showed some of their firepower, but must learn to keep it going for 60 minutes.
I think overall, I think we learned a lot in that football game. I think we matured in that football game, and I think you're going to see a much improved football team coming up this next week.
The midshipmen now return home with an 0-1 record to host Kent State, where they hope to take out their frustrations of their opening night loss on the Golden Flashes. Petty Officer Scott Prather, Navy Marine Corps News.